initial receiver, Dennis Phillips, and now the Indians want it.
West Main and DuCoyne, where for...
DuCoyne comes out of its timeout. The fourth and three from the Robinson 5-yard line.
First big play of the ball game, fourth down at the Robinson 5. Carnes, option, keeps it, pitches to Jason James. He's through. Touchdown, DuCoyne. Great. Step six, we'll try to make it seven. The kick, it's long enough, and it's straight through. It's good. 5-4 to Normal with the Indians.
When your car starts having...
Find out. Carnes set the kick from the near hash mark. Down top, Aaron Ritter and Andre Sherrill, the three speedsters, as a good long kick. It's going to be taken by Brandon Trueblood at the seven. He's up the middle of the field. He's in some traffic, and he's hit three or four times, and Mike Porter makes a play with Pat Tolliver.
Coach Terry Roach spends a lot of his time, Steve, in the press box calling the signals, and it's the assistant coaches that give the plays from the sideline.
First down and 10 for Louis Hartridge. He looks to throw. He's looking, he's looking. He's got some people open, and it's complete to number 42. At the 50-yard line, he's brought down by Pat Tolliver.
Trying to stay away from was giving up that pass, and they had some pressure on Hartridge, but he got the pass away.
Inside handoff to the fullback, and he rambles for about 8 or 9 yards. That's number 34, Jake Baxter. Second down and one. Handoff. Again, it's Baxter, and he rambles down near the 25-yard line for a big first down. I thought they might have had their lines, their plays called in advance, but they don't. Hartridge keeps it on the option. He's got plenty of running room, and he stopped, and he's going to be wrapped up at the 20 by a host of Indians, but not before he gets Maroon of Robinson, and they're on the move. Second down and five, handoff to Trueblood up the middle. He's got big running room, and he's down near the 10-yard line. Hartridge, quick hitter, looks to throw, second man through, and he's going to be stopped up. That's a 10, they've got to get to the 2. Handoff, second man through, it's Fiskus, and he's going to be wrapped up at the 5. It'll bring up a 3rd.
The Indians are going to have to take some time and dig in, and they don't have much in this no-huddle offense, but they can get a little.
Hartridge calling signals. He runs it, and it's going to be... a first down by Fiskus down near the goal line. They ran it first and goal to goal at the 1-yard line. The way they're moving the ball, Tim, I'm sure they'll get it in 4 plays.
Unless there's a fumble.
Hartridge keeps it. Fumble! And he keeps it. He gets on it back at the 4-yard line.
A missed handoff.
Play. Looks for the sideline, rather, to get the play. Minute 57 left in the quarter. Wishbone set. They give it. The option play. He pitches. Touchdown, Nathan Trueblood. They're going to run a play. It's a quick pitch to Trueblood, and he's going to get in, and it's going to be 8-7. 8-7, Robinson leads it. Minute 47 to go in the first quarter. This is DuCoyne.
Here's the kickoff after touchdown.
There's the kick. Line drive goes through. Going to roll around, and it's going to be picked up back at the goal line. They thought it was going to get in, and Rob Eaton's in a world of hurt at the 10-yard line. That ball died at the 1. It looked like it was going to go in, but DuCoyne will take over first and 10 at their own 10. A minute 42 left to go.
Mud, and he decided he was going to let it go. The only problem was it wouldn't get into the end zone.
Carnes. Handoff. Jared Reed, and Reed runs... 4-7 is DuCoyne will try to mount together a drive deep in their own territory. Carnes, second man through, it's Jason James, and Jason James is out near the 20-yard line, which here to be mostly a defensive man, but he's capable of opening some big holes also. Third down and about a half a yard for the Indians. Handoff goes to Jared Reed, and he's got a fair play. It's Robinson 8, DuCoyne 7. You're on the
same way.
Yeah, Massac made us mad, and they didn't want to do that. Let's see if we don't do the same thing here. This Robinson team's a lot better than Massac County, though. Second man through, Rob Eaton, and he's hit by a couple of defenders, and he'll second down and 8 from the 25. Just started the second period. Carnes looks to throw. He does. He's got Robbie.
Oh, what a catch.
Let's see if it's incomplete. It's incomplete.
I don't know.
Eaton's fingertips. He was the only one who could have caught that ball.
They've got the spread lineup in now. Wide receivers everywhere for Duke Coin. Carnes looks to throw. Looks like he's going to keep it, and he's going to be ran out of bounds near the 30. It's going to be fourth down and from Van Meter Field. Carnes stands back at his 18-yard line. He'll wait the snap from Jared Reed. It's a good one. Jason Carnes gets a good kick away. Number 42 takes it back to 32. He's up the middle of the field, and he's going to be stopped.
Ouch.
And we've got a penalty clipping against Robinson.
Didn't have to take time out to get a signal from the sideline, and that made things a lot quicker. Let's see if they have the same thing.
The first man through, the fullback, the ball's resting at the 30. 10:30 to play in the second as the quarterback's calling the signals. Partridge, he's a good one. Robinson leads it. Penalty
on one of the linemen.
Seven on a very impressive drive and a two-point conversion.
They've been slow a little bit here, Steve. Let's hope that comes to DuCoin's advantage.
Partridge looks to throw. Screen pass. Tolliver misses him. He's loose. Big gain for this team. He could go. He is going to go. Jason James is the only man.
Sean Martin's going to catch him from behind.
Down at the 14-yard line, but that play should have went nowhere. And instead, it's going to be first and goal to
10-yard line. And Sean Margram's sprinter speed is the only thing to save the touchdown.
Jake Baxter caught the pass and was hit, spun around. Everything is ready to score again. Hand off to Fiskus. He spins, and he's going to be stopped at the 10. Jason Carnes makes the play. Partridge, who did fumble the last time they were down there around the goal line. There's some shifting, and there's two men shifting against Robinson. Robinson's coming. 10, 20, 28.
Robinson in the game so far has 60 receivers to the near side.
Partridge looks to throw. He's under pressure, thrown across the middle. Loose ball incomplete. Partridge calling some signals. Looks at the coaching staff to get the final word. He looks to throw. He slips. He's going to be hit.
Loose, and DuCoin's got it.
I think DuCoin's got it.
Banging on the door again, and the momentum shifted drastically after that penalty. The Indians now have a chance to go back on top.
Carnes, wishbone set. Hand off, Rob Eaton. Looks around. He'll get one or two, maybe. Ran off the left.
DuCoin only had the ball for three plays in the front, but Robinson seems to have shut down the DuCoin offense, at least temporarily.
Carnes looks to throw. Almost picked off.
Second, you talked about him. He's also a sophomore.
He's a dandy. Carnes. Rolling penalty flags, probably a motion call. Dennis Phillips is complete up at the attack.
Oh, absolutely here. They've got that Illinois set, and they've got all the speedsters in there.
Rob Eaton is the man where Reed usually stands behind Carnes. Across the middle, Rob Eaton, he has it. He's on his feet.
Oh, nice cut.
He's going to have a first down at the 47-yard line.
Nice cut by Robbie.
First and 10 up at the 47. Jason Carnes hands off Margram to the outside. Penalty flags, and he's going to be tripped up.
And that's on keeping this game moving. The first quarter went by really quick. The second quarter seems to have drug on a little bit.
Carnes, wide receivers everywhere for him. Handoff, draw play. Big yardage. Jared Reed is going to be brought back near the original line of scrimmage. Phillips near side, Saunders far side. Margram also flanked over on the far side. Carnes looks to throw. Quick hitter, Dennis Phillips has it. He's got it, and he's going to have a first down down at the Robinson. James and Phillips to the far, to the near side. Saunders to the far side. Reed and Eaton in the backfield. Reed up the middle. He rambles for a few yards down near the
in that left guard there. Nathan Morgenstern.
Second down and 5 for the Indians. Saunders far side, Phillips near side. Carnes busted play. He's going to try to do what he can.
Oh, what a block by Eaton.
And he gets back to the line of scrimmage.
After missing the handoff.
And we're in the two down situation now. Phillips near side, Saunders far side, wishbone formation. Cross Buck, Rob Eaton up the middle. He's still loose. He's going to be dropped down at the 13-yard.
Now it's running attack for the Indians.
Last year, Reed was the, or Tony Goldman got 30 yards rushing. Reed was second with 27, so a different scenario this afternoon. Carnes to Reed, and Reed stood up at the line of scrimmage. He may get work.
Seifert had to come out to have some equipment worked on.
Cecil's a capable man and a junior. Carnes, wishbone set. Handoff, fumble, and I think Robinson got it.
I'm not sure. Carnes had a hold of it, but not enough, and Robinson has the ball.
3:48 left in the first half, and it's first and 10, Robinson at the 20. We've got two timeouts, and they can really move the football.
I'm not sure who recovered that fumble, Steve, but it was a big play.
True Blood, the second man through, and he goes nowhere. Partridge calling signals. There's a flag. It's a moot. Robinson, quick hitter. Nope, option pitch. And Fiskus, Carnes, and Rob Eaton on a mix-up in the backfield gave Robinson the ball. Handoff up the middle to True Blood, I think, and he's going to have our 8-7. Partridge. He's going to throw. He goes long. Incomplete.
He overthrew it.
They were two big completions. Second down and 10 for Partridge and his crew from Robinson. He fakes. He looks to throw. He's going to be sacked.
Oh, my.
Partridge calling the signals.
Matt Seifert is just outstandingly quick, and he blitzed from that left side and had a clear shot at the quarterback.
Let's see if we can't pick a pass off. Man in motion is Fiskus to the far side. Partridge rolling. He throws. Hits
and drops.
Jared Reed had it in his hand.
He had it picked off and might have had six. He was open. But the ball went through his hands.
There's the snap. It's a low one. Almost get it. The ball bounces at the 42, and Rob Eaton's going to get away from it at the 30, and it'll be first and 10 DuCoin at the 30s in DuCoin for world famous. Bringing you Indian football today, we've got 58 seconds left in the first half, and DuCoin is 71 yards away from Pater. Carnes, fumble, he picks it up. He skirts one man, throws across the field, Dennis Phillips, and Dennis Phillips is going to be stopped at the 40.
Turn. That was near disaster, and it turned into a good play for the Indians.
Carnes to Eaton. He completes it, but he had to fall down.
Play from both sides gave him the 2 yards and kept the clock running, forced the Indians into a timeout. I think he's a little frustrated with himself because he knew he could have stayed on his feet.
Carnes fakes, looks. He's going to have to keep it, and he's going to pick up a couple. 12 seconds left, and Indians want timeout with 10 seconds remaining now. They're going to try to go long. Carnes, under center, three receivers to the near side.
Eric Saunders along to the left, to the far side.
Carnes heaves it up. Picked off the 10 at the 41 with 3 seconds left in the first half.
And again, the Robinson coaching staff working the officials on that far sideline. Maybe they can work them into another penalty.
Carnes almost slips, fakes, screen across the middle, and that'll be the end of the first half. 0.7, you're on the road to normal with the Indians. 8-7. Carnes is set to kick off. Here he comes. Line drive kick, bouncing around. It's going to be picked up by True Blood at the 13. He's up the middle of the field. He's got a gap. Pat Tolliver closes it, and at the 29-yard line is where he calls what he wants to from up here. It's a good vantage point. You can see what's going on. Definitely more than you can down the handoff. First play, Pat Tolliver stacks up the. They've got to get to the 40 for a first down. Handoff. is the big fullback, and he's going to be stopped near a first down out at the 39.
Letting him get the second effort.
Third down and fumble, loose ball. Let's see who has it.
I think the Maroons might have it. For the Maroons, they've recovered two of them. However, one time David Hill fell on the loose ball.
First and 10 at the 40, just outside the 40. Partridge calls a lot of signals. A man in motion, the tight end was the fullback. Another man in motion. Handoff to Fiskus and Leon Talbert right left now. Partridge calling signals for Robinson. The line is set. They hand off on the option play. Adam Hill takes him down and a short
the play, and he made the stop.
No huddle offense is what Robinson's been in all day. Option left this time. Pitches. Loose ball. Loose ball.
Everybody in it.
I think David Hill got it. Again, Tim, that Al Morton thinks we might be able to block a punt. Rob Eaton, they're going to set up a return.
Partridge gets under center and then comes back out before they're set. The punter for Robinson is Jacob Baxter.
Low snap. Almost. Rob Eaton will let it bounce. No, he's going to pick it up at the 20. And he's going to be hit at the 19, and he's going to go down. Good coverage by the Maroons, and it'll be first 8:15 left in the third quarter.
And the adjustments were made at halftime. We talked about it during the halftime show. DeCoin did the thing it needed to do. Now it needs to score.
Carnes to Reed, the first back through, and he picks up a couple out to around the 21.
30 left in the game. DeCoin could drive down and punch it in right before the end of the ball game.
That's wishful thinking, and I'd still like to be behind in the fourth quarter. Carnes will throw. He's looking. He's got Dennis Phillips, and he's got him complete. But when you've got big 6'4", lanky Dennis Phillips on your team, it's always an advantage. Carnes behind center. Second man through is Jason James, and Jason pops outside, and he's going to be stopped at the 36. Now it's second down and 5, along 6, up at the 42. Carnes to Reed, and he's followed up for nothing. Get a first down. Third down and 6. Robinson with a 6-man front. Double tight ends for DuCoin. Carnes looks to throw. He's under pressure. Penalty flag. He lofts it. It's through the hands of Dennis Phillips and out of bounds, but that's going to be
signaling decline right away. They do decline.
Standing around their own 20. Here's the snap to Carnes. Carnes' kick is a high one. It's rather short. It's winding toward the sideline, and it hits the 30. The marker over to 30, and they'll spot it.
And
Carnes kicked the extra point to make it 7-0, and now they come back 8-7. Quick hitter on the pitch to True Blood. And he's wrapped up by Carnes. Let them score anymore because we've got, if we were to let them score and we score, we've got to make a two-point conversion. Hand off to True Blood. He goes near the circle line. It'll be third down and about 4.5.
Against the two-point conversion earlier.
4:20 left to go in the third quarter. We've got to stop them here. Partridge, man in motion is Fiskus to the far side. Looks to throw. It's complete to number 85. Jeff Blacker has just picked out the guy that wasn't covered. Quick hitter up the middle is Baxter, and he gets about 5 over the second and a short 5 from the 48. Both teams have fumbled a lot today. Let's see if maybe the Indians can make a big play. True Blood in motion. Reversed. And third down and a long 3, we will call it. Quick hitter. First down for Baxter and Moore as he's down over the 40 to the 39 where Jason 304 and counting in the third quarter. Robinson again leads it by a single point. There's the handoff again. And he picks up several yards as Tom
slipping in that situation.
They're right in a slick portion of the field. The water seeped through on the tarp. Partridge, wishbone set. Second man through. Oh, and the tight end. Wishbone set with Fox to the near side. Partridge yelling out signals. The line is set. He keeps it, and he's going to be stopped at the 30 by 1 point, and they're on the move at fourth down and two from the 30. They got to get to the 28. This could be a very, very big play. Now come the ball game.
Quick hitter, and he's going to stop.
He's with a minute 26 here on the fourth and two play. Wishbone set for Carnes. Carnes, the first man through is Reed, and Reed picks up several yards.
Close to three.
Wishbone formation. Saunders far side, Phillips near side. Jason Carnes barking signals. Hand off Rob Eaton. He cuts up the middle, and he's going to be stopped back. It'll be third down and four as we start the fourth period.
Model GSD 1120R, now selling for $469.95. Receive three boxes of Cascade with purchase. All this at Guthrie Appliance in DuCoin. Their business was built with service before and after the sale. Use your DuCoin dollars when shopping for your GE appliances. Also come in and register for Guthrie's door prop.
11:40 left in the ballgame. DuCoin trails by a point. Carnes to Margram. Margram up the middle, and he's going to be stopped up at the 45.
And we'll have to check on Margram.
Second down and eight again for the Indians. Penalty flags fly.
Left side, good point line on the left side.
Motion, one back, two wing backs. Saunders near side, Phillips far side. Excuse me. Second down, 13, we're DuCoin. Carnes rolls. He's under pressure. He throws. Complete to Saunders. Incomplete. They say he's incomplete. Goes a little further. Carnes, two-step drop, throws. Dennis Phillips. He's complete, and he might have a first down. He's got the first down. That would be a big loss. David Hill checks in at that wideout with Saunders. Wishbone set, first and 10, DuCoin. 10 minutes left in the ballgame. Handoff, Rob Eaton. He's hit, bounces again and goes nowhere. 1-10 with 9:29 left in the contest. I feel, Jeff, that we've got to score here or the ballgame's over with. Carnes on the option. He looks. He keeps it.
Oh, what
he's
a great play.
He's going all the way.
Touchdown.
Huge play for the Indians. And I think this is because if they get it, then DuCoin has, then Robinson has to go for two to win the ball game.
Double tight end. Wishbone set. Carnes looks to throw. He throws.
This Thanksgiving.
Not him because you're going to force Robinson to make a big choice if they do score. Line drive kick, it's angling out of bounds off the side of his foot, and Robinson receptions that drive, Tim.
This ball's in a lot drier territory right now, Steve, where it's at the 35.
Carnes gets a high kick toward the middle of the field. Fiskus takes it at the 17. He's headed up the middle. Donald Topp puts a hit on him, and that's where he's going to count stadium for the 3A crown.
Robinson was there last year. DuCoin wants to be there this year.
8:50 and counting. Hartrich, quick hitter. Hand off True Blood. He goes nowhere. Matt Seifert, Leon Talbert stopping him now. They're on the move.
True Blood almost lost that handoff, too.
Yes. They're right in a very swampy part of the field, up at the 33-yard line. Second down and nine. First man through is Baxter, and he gets a big hole. Still on his feet. Carnes dropped him to the turf up at the 10. From the 43, the Maroons have the football, and they're on the drive with 8 minutes left in the ballgame. Hartrich, Lewis Hartrich, calling signals for the Maroons. Their line set. Handoff, True Blood up the middle. He's got big running room, and he's going to be near it. And this is going to come down to some big decision-making by both coaching staff. Second man through is Fiskus. And Fiskus gets up, need a big play. We need to get him in the third down long. There's some movement, but they're going to say, and there it is, Baxter go back. The Robinson line. Nice set. First man,
goes nowhere.
We're in a tough formation, but we've got
Patriot Junior Center, and I'm not sure that they're going to punt the ball.
He drops back.
I'm still not
and they're
sure.
Going to call time. They're going to go for it. Partridge. They're going to call timeout again, and that's the second timeout used by Robinson.
Back here at Van Meter Field. Going on fourth and four.
He's going to throw. He's under pressure from Seifert. Seifert has him left. And they're going to the grounding flag. There ought to be a drive.
4 second drive, Steve.
No time for a fumble now from the Indians. Carnes to Reed. Jared Reed. Loose ball. And Robinson picks it up at the 40.
They made some big stands the last time out on the field. Let's see if they can do it now.
Quick pitch to Biscuits, far side. He cuts up, and he picks up five or six. Adam Hill was there to... First man is the big boy, Baxter, and he's the senior. Partridge calling signals. Wishbone set for Robinson. Second man through is Biscuits. He goes nowhere. Matt Seifert.
Partridge. Maybe a passing situation here for the Marines.
They've got two guys flanked out. He lifts the throw. He throws. It's complete. He'll be short of a first down. Adam Hill makes the play on the tight end. Little play action pass. Wishbone set now. Third and a long two, a big play for the Maroons. Quick hitter, and Baxter falls forward for a first and extra point. Partridge. Handoff. Option. He's going to be dropped for a loss.
This play right here, make it third and long.
Partridge. Calling signals. The line is set. Partridge looks to throw. It's going to be a screen pass. He dumps it to Trueblood. Trueblood.
And again, Reed.
Jared Reed makes an outstanding.
Get right there on that screen. Reed with an ankle tackle will save a big gainer.
Partridge. Calling signals for Robinson. In motion goes Trueblood. He looks to throw. He looks to throw again. The guy falls down. He heaves it up in the air. It's going to be knocked out in the first. Partridge calling signals. 2:04 left on the game clock. Partridge. First, he keeps it on the option play. Cuts it in. He's still loose, and he's going to be brought down near the...
It's in the Maroons, and now right here is a goal being needed by the Indians.
Wishbone set, number tight end for Robinson. Second man through, and he's going to keep it to quarterback. No gain. Robinson set it to the right. Partridge will look back and call signals. Second down and a yard to go for a touchdown. Partridge. We'll run the option. And he got stopped. Third down and about less than a yard. Touchdown, Robinson. They ran the option. Partridge.